We're trying to equip coaches with the tools and knowledge that often college and high school coaches are never really exposed to.
We think that we coach the way we coach because there's no other way to coach.
It's about honestly looking back at yourself and reflecting on how you've approached coaching to this point and the experience and the culture that you're creating for your athletes.
The hope is that they're seeing new possibilities for what they're doing, that they're becoming aware of aspects of their coaching that they weren't conscious of before.
So they can say, okay, now I understand why we're training this way. I understand why we're doing this type of drill and why we keep repeating these types of things.
We spend hundreds of hours talking about how to defend the pick and roll and how to best lay down a sacrifice bunt, but how much time do we spend teaching these athletes how to lead?
Picture getting a package in the mail of all the possible things that you could do to be a great coach, and then setting it off as like a firecracker. Pow!
We provide concrete, specific research that backs up certain strategies and beliefs around working with adolescents.
Being able to have suggestions put out there to kind of look at what you do and say, oh, is what I'm doing supported by science or not?
Too often, our coaches are not provided any research that is so relevant and needed for us to hear so that we can grow and be more effective.
As a coach, you can be a mentor to your athletes. As a coach, you can also be a mentor to an assistant coach. Mentoring is no better way to sort of empower and keep coaches in the field for the long haul.
You're excited about what's happening here, but you're even more excited about what's going to happen when you go home.
They're given tools that they will then be able to use in order to develop the best coaching strategies they can find for their style.
And I think when they walk out of here, not only are they energized, but they have plans, they have strategies, they have tools.
I think NCLI is constantly challenging us to think about why we do what we do and then making us realize, oh my gosh, look at these other options. And it's forcing us to see that there are actually some pretty rational reasons for doing things differently than most coaches do things.